Hi friends, and today we are going to discuss from final accounts, and which is very important area in just not foundation at any level of examination. Already as far as final accounts concerned, simple pro forma trading P&L balance sheet and all the adjustments and already uploaded. So now I would like to discuss in detail of all the problems which are given in the ICA. So let us discuss ICA material problems one by one, okay? Let us see the first one. The balance in financial year ended 31st March 2017 of Messrs. Deepakshi shows the following details. Purchases and sales given. Debit side 10 lakhs is a purchase. Credit side 12 lakhs is a sales. Debtors, creditors given. 5 lakhs debtor, 4 lakhs creditors. Opening stock 2 lakhs. Closing stock 3 lakhs. Other expenses and incomes 7 lakhs and expenses 9 lakhs incomes. Fixed assets and long term liabilities. Fixed assets 25 lakhs, long term liabilities 6 lakhs, capital 21 lakhs. The trial balance total is given like this. We also provided some additional information, that is creditors in the beginning, opening creditors. In the year beginning, creditors 3 lakhs you are given. You are required to calculate the cost of goods sold and amount paid to creditors. Both these points we need to work out. Okay, let us work out both of these points. Right? First of all, what is the first point I need to work out here? Cost of goods sold. How cost of goods sold will come? Opening stock plus purchases plus direct expenses minus closing stock. That is the cost of goods sold. Cost of goods sold. To say the cost of goods sold, there are two formulas. So one is a direct formula, which is opening stock plus purchases plus direct expenses minus closing stock. And by another way also you may find out the cost of goods sold by the indirect way, sales minus gross profit. That is also cost of goods sold formula. But let us apply here first formula, opening stock plus purchases plus direct expenses minus closing stock. But of course here in the given problem there are no any specified direct expenses, just you can ignore that. Therefore we can say cost of goods sold is equal to simply opening stock purchases minus closing stock. Okay, by this applying this formula, simply we can find out the cost of goods sold by the provided details. First, I would like to take the opening stock, which is 2 lakhs here. Okay, now I want to take the purchases. But here I can say the purchases, which is given 10 lakhs, it is what we can say adjusted purchases. Okay, that closing stock is already adjusted to that purchases. So, which is given 10 lakhs rupees. Purchases, this purchases already being deducted by closing stock. We know that closing stock, what does it mean closing stock? At the end of the period, if any stock left with us as unsold, which is called closing stock. For that, at the end of the year, if it is normally given like a closing stock, like adjustments, the entry is always like closing stock account, it had to trading account. So closing stock is always asset debit side, and according to matching concept, it should be created to trading account. Matching concept means, so out of the purchased goods, if some of goods are not sold, which means not generated any revenue, and obviously they should not be shown like a cost, it should be eliminated. That's why you can credit to the trading account. So closing stock account, it to trading account. So what actually during the year itself, if accountant is able to know the closing stock, he can, instead of crediting to trading account, he can directly reduce the purchases. So that entry written by him like during this year, closing stock account it had to purchases. Instead of crediting to trading account, during the year itself I know that. So, and I can generate the closing stock like asset. So I can reduce my purchases to the extent of three. This is already done. How do we say this entry is recorded? Because closing stock is already given in the trial balance. So that this is already adjusted towards purchases. Okay, purchase is reduced and closing stock is generated. And therefore, what I said, that opening stock plus purchases minus closing stock. Minus closing stock in the sense, in the purchases already closing stock being reduced. Closing stock already removed from the purchases. Actually, you have to supposed to do deduct here, but already it is deducted. Opening stock plus adjusted purchases, which means purchases minus closing stock, which is called adjusted purchases. This is what we can say cost of goods sold, 12 lakhs. Opening stock plus adjusted purchases, which is nothing but purchases minus closing stock, adjusted purchases, and resulting amount is the cost of goods sold 12 lakhs. As I said that when you see closing stock in trial balance, we can say this entry was already written by the accountant, because already they know closing stock, how much is left out of the purchases, closing stock generated asset and purchase being already reduced. Instead of crediting trading account, closing stock to trading account. Okay. And next, another point is, second point, along with cost of goods sold, we need to find out another point is payment made to creditors. So amount paid to creditors, we need to work out. By having simply creditors account, we can say the payment to creditors. Already opening balance is given 3 lakhs. In the trial balance given, closing balance is creditors, 4 lakhs. 3 lakhs, close 4 lakhs is given. We know the entry for purchases, purchase to creditors, in the creditors buy purchases, payment to creditor, creditor to bank. This is the balancing figure we need to work out, but we need to write here purchases. But while taking purchases, whatever the purchases given in trial balance, that purchases already being, that is reduced by closing stock, whatever the stock left, purchase is being reduced and closing stock is generated. But while that is also purchase of during this year, therefore that should be added. Purchases given in trial balance, it is being added closing stock, because which is trial balance purchases, that is already deducted by the closing stock, but that is also purchase of this year, so it should be added back. Therefore total purchases made 13 lakhs. So purchase to creditors, in the creditors by purchases 13 lakhs, and of course balancing figure is simply payment to creditor, creditor to bank account, that's all. Okay, simply cost of goods sold. First point is cost of goods sold. It can be known by the opening stock plus purchases minus closing stock. Opening stock is given, purchase is given, purchases already adjusted by the closing stock. Okay, so closing stock to purchase entry being already written, purchase being already reduced. So need not to closing stock, you have to minus here, that already out of purchases, it is already being deducted here. Therefore, simply we can say this is what the cost of goods sold. And moreover, creditors, opening creditor given, closing creditor given, payment to creditor, purchases, both are missing figure. Purchases already given, but the thing is, for purchases, closing stock to be added back, because closing stock already being deducted, that should be added back. So then you can take the purchases, balancing figure we can say creditors to bank account. Okay, that's all. That is a simple way to solve the illustration one. Let us discuss the illustration 2 also, and you are given the data like this: opening inventory, which is opening stock, trading debit, purchases, trading debit, carriage inward, direct expense, trading debit, wages, trading debit, sales, trading credit, return inward, which is minus from sales, which is sales return, return outward, which is minus from purchases, purchase return, closing inventory, trading account, credit side. Okay, so we can take all these items and let us find out the GP through the trading account. You are, by the provided details, find out the trading account and also pass the necessary closing entries. All these ledgers to be closed, obviously by transferring to the trading account. All opening stock purchases, direct expenses will be transferred by transferring to trading account. Sales and closing stock will be transferred to the trading account credit side. The resulting amount is a GP. Let us take that first of all, two opening inventory. 1 lakh. The next one, purchases, right in inner column, 6,72,000. Minus purchase returns, which is return outward, which is 72,000. Net amount 6 lakhs. Carriage inwards 30,000. Direct expense. Wages 50,000. Direct expense. Wages is a direct expense. Sales trading account, credit side in inner column, 11 lakhs. Minus sales return. Okay. Return inward 1 lakh, outer column 10 lakhs, closing stock 2 lakhs, 12 lakhs credit total right here. 12 lakhs to gross profit transfer to P&L account. Okay, so the gross profit resulting amount is 4,20,000. So this is the simple way, and to prepare a trading account, find out the gross profit. Let us see how journal, in the journal proper we used to write entries. Okay, of course all these entries at the end of the period 2016 March 31st we are going to write it, all the entries. Okay, 2016 March 31st we are going to write down all the, sorry, this is 2017, right? 2017, right here and there, 2017. First of all, I would like to write the purchase returns to the purchase account first. Purchase returns to be closed by transferring to purchase account, then it will be like a net purchase. Purchase return always credit side, bring in the debit side. So purchase return account data are to purchases account 72,000, being purchase return transferred to purchases account, being purchase return transferred to the purchase account. Similarly, sales return also should be transferred to sales account, for which entry sales account data are to sales return account 1 lakh, being sales return transferred to sales account. Automatically sales purchases and they have been right now, and they come to the net figures. Okay, but of course here writing and you have to show like a deduction, but actually those accounts will be like a net balance. They used to come directly, purchases will come here, net purchases, net sales will come here. But of course to have the more clarity, and we are going to show like a deduction there, right? Okay, so then I am going to write in the trading account all these items are to be debited. Trading account data are to opening stock, to purchases, to opening stock 1 lakh, to purchases 6 lakhs, to carriage inward 30,000, 30,000, to wages 50,000, 50,000, total 7,80,000. Narration, being transfer of opening stock, comma purchases, comma carriage inward and wages to trading account. Trading account. Like that, sales also should be transferred, sales and closing stock. Sales account data to trading account 10 lakhs, narration being sales transfer to trading account. But of course along with this you can write closing stock also here, but you may write separately also closing stock, because it is a normally that is item you have to value separately. Mostly it is given like a closing stock adjustment item, not a regular item. So closing stock you may write separately, or you can write with this also, no problem. Closing stock account data to trading account 2 lakhs. Closing stock account data to 2 lakhs. Narration, so being closing stock is valued and here the resulting amount, whatever you see, and all this is written and this is also written. Out of the trading account result will go to P&L account. Entry simply trading account at R2, profit and loss account. The gross profit 4,20,000. 4,20,000. Narration the being gross profit transferred to being gross profit transferred to the profit and loss account. Okay, so that's all. This is a simple way to solve the second problem, and we can discuss the remaining problems in the further classes. Okay, bye.